Communication. Models of communication. Many theorists have given some diagrammatic representations of communication process. In this module, we will see mass communication model. At the end of the session, you will be able to illustrate mass communication model. You all are aware of mass media and mass communication. Why do we call this as mass communication? Let us see. In face-to-face communication, we are in a similar physical environment. Whatever we say according to the system, symbolic system of the learners. If we talk or if we show something, we don't generally require machinery, because our simple speech can be heard by the learners, our simple visual can be seen by the learners. How many students do we have in our classrooms? Sometimes up to 100 also. Even if we have 100 persons sitting in our class, we talk to them, we show them something, we give them some activities. But how's about reaching to 200, 250, 300, 400, 500 and 5000 learners? Here, the communication media and the symbolic systems become complex. We cannot use our vocal cord for reaching to 500 persons. We cannot reach to 5000, 10000 learners just by speaking. We need to bring in new media and new symbolic systems. So, in mass communication, we require machinery. You can see that in face-to-face communication, teacher is in the classroom, and in mass communication, teacher is talking through television set, or teacher may talk through webcasting. Mass communication model does not talk about sender and receiver simply. We talk about information source, because one particular person may not become a sender. We may require a system. For example, if we are recording a particular instructor's lecture or speech, then the entire system works for that. Simple recording of a lecture requires a few hours, a few machinery, and a few personnel. When that lecture is transmitted, we require transmitting facility, transmitting machinery. So, transmitter comes into the picture. This transmitter sends signals to the receiver. Now, the actual receiver is sitting at the destination, which simply cannot understand the signals sent by the information source. So, we need a system of receiver which converts signals sent by the transmitter in the form through which destination will understand the signals. We can say that in mass communication, large number of persons spread over the large area are addressed from a single source. Because nobody can directly send them any message, the message needs to be transmitted, and the transmitter receives the message, then transmits the message in the form of signals. The signals also cannot be received directly by the destination, so we require receiver set to receive these signals, and these signals get converted into the message by that receiver. Ultimately, individual person sitting at the destination receive this message from receiver. Let us take an example. Open University records some lectures, So recorded lectures is the message which is sent, captured by the satellite through electromagnetic waves. Now this satellite transmits these lectures. Dish antenna receives these lectures, and through television set, students see recorded lectures. So the same message, the way teacher had recorded, the similar way students also see the teacher, but through television set. And satellite to dish antenna is the journey of the message in form of electromagnetic waves. This is how mass communication takes place.